Imagine having no other option other than spending the rest of your life in a hospital. And it's not because you are sick, but because your relatives have abandoned you. The Meru Level 5 Hospital has been home to a number of abandoned persons, receiving at least four of them every month. Here now is the story of hospital residents christened the unknown.
Meru Level 5 Hospital is a typical hospital. Frida Gaki lives here. Her bright smile barely her situation as she is wheeled out of the hospital for her routine bask in the sun. The five-year-old was diagnosed with cerebral palsy right after her birth. Frida was born here and was abandoned by her mother shortly after her birth.
So we tried to trace the mother. We never got the mother. We tried to follow the addresses that were left in the file through our social worker, but nobody seemed to know the mother in that locality.
And Frida isn't the only one here who calls the hospital home. There are at least four patients abandoned at the Meru Level 5 Hospital every month. The hospital's personnel is having quite a hard time trying to trace their families. You heard right. The patient is identified as unknown. She occupies bed number 33. She has been here since 2012 when she was admitted while unconscious. When she regained consciousness, it was discovered that she had lost her memory.
The name that she knows herself with is the name we nicknamed her when she came here, and the name is Unknown. And when you call Unknown, she responds.
2 years down the line, she continues to live at the hospital. She has nowhere else to go. She has no one else in this world other than the hospital personnel and her fellow patients. These are the only people she knows.
Unknown has known Meru General Hospital, Meru Level 5 Hospital, as her home. Up to date, if you ask her if she wants to go home, she tells no, she's not comfortable.
Behind the psychiatry department's door lies the same script but a different cast. Margaret Cairo was abandoned at Nairobi's Mathare Hospital in 1961. She, however, ended up in Meru in 2006 after social workers traced her lineage to the town.
Unfortunately, we were turned about by the community because they said the family died out. That's what we found from the ground, but we cannot be sure that this is what was there, because whenever you are diagnosed with mental illness, people don't want to hear for you in the community.
Maitha King'ong'o has some scanty information about his past, but this is not enough to trace his relatives.
He has a language that he speaks, that's neologism. Neologism is a one cloning of ones, but we communicate with them with Gikamba.
The hospital is forced to adjust its budget to accommodate patients like these who may never ever leave. Ian Wafula, KTN.